So let's have your introduction, please.
Sure. My name is Nitai Utkarsh. I work in the family office space. So I've been in this space for the last, for more than a decade now. So my primary role is to lead the family office activities, which includes investments, succession planning, looking at corporate businesses owned by the family, and many other things that a family would need, typical ultra high net worth family would need.
So since you work for the family office, we would like to hear about some of the recent trends that have come up in the family office business.
So I think one of the most important things that has happened is that the entire family office business has become quite big in India. Primary reason for that is that the second generation of most business families have come back to India after their studies. And they have seen this kind of a concept work in the US or in Europe or most of the Western countries. So they've come back with those ideas and they want their parents to now look at setting up a family office. The primary objective of setting this up is to really look at how to create and preserve your personal wealth. Because most of the Indian business families have been growing their businesses. All their wealth is tied up into their businesses. This is the first time that they're now thinking that, okay, how can I look at my family's personal wealth, something that I can give to my next generation? Because, you know, today's next generation may not be interested in running their father's businesses. They may want to do something completely new, completely off the cuff, for which they need money. Unfortunately, Indian family patriarchs don't have that money because it's locked into their businesses. So family office is a good way of ensuring that some money is taken out of the business, kept in the personal books, looked after properly, and then the succession is planned accordingly.
Right. As you pointed out yourself, now the next generation consists of millennials. So what are the different kind of trends? What are the new working ways that you have observed with the millennials while working for the family offices?
A lot of changes have started coming in. Some of the things that used to be, some things that were sought after are becoming more hygiene now, especially related to technology. So everything needs to be available on the mobile, all the information, data, anything to do with the portfolio, everything needs to be available on the mobile, on demand. And these are hygiene factors now, so they're not really sought after. The investment trends are changing because most of the millennials are looking at a sharing economy rather than an ownership economy. So instead of buying assets, they're willing to share assets. They really focus a lot on service as a concept rather than a product as a concept. And plus, obviously, I mean, to make a product business successful, it takes a lot. So there are a lot of investments happening in B2B service businesses, SaaS businesses, there is a lot of investment happening in shared economy businesses. So I think those are investment trends that the millennials are driving. And within family offices, I think the way in which family offices are structured, the way ideas are discussed, the way technology is used, not everything has to be done over a meeting, it can be done over a VC, over an audio call. So all those things are changing. These are small changes, but I think they're making a big difference in the way family offices work.
So you are also into investments and you are an investor yourself. So now that India is opening up, the economy is opening up and there are a lot of startups and you have been in the business for a very long time. So what are the kind of changes and differences that you have observed over a period of time as far as the investments are concerned?
So I think transparency has become very important in investments. Earlier, there was a lot of opaque stuff that used to go around where investors did not really know what was happening and investments were more of a pure investing phenomenon. So, but now I think people have become more aware. The information has become standardized. So any startup that is looking at raising money from investors is supposed to now be very clear and transparent about what they want to do, where they are currently, what are the numbers that they're looking at. So all those things have helped the investors also streamline their investments. So that's become a big trend, so to say.
And these have been about my questions, but I would like to hear from you about your experience as a family office manager.
It's a nascent industry yet in India, but it's been a great experience so far. I've had the good fortune of working with a lot of families, firstly on the sell side of the table when I was advising multiple families on setting up their family offices, and now on the other side of the table where I'm really working for a particular family and having set up their family office, looking to perform various activities under that. So it's been a great learning experience. I've had the fortune of talking and meeting with a lot of family offices worldwide. And I think the primary focus of all these family offices or professionals working there is to ensure that the family that they're working for gets everything that they want in a way in which it can be organized in the most efficient manner possible. So which is what everybody is focusing on. I think there is a big case for all of us in this industry to exchange notes, keep sharing what we are doing, the best practices, so that everybody gets enriched. And I think it's a great journey.
Thank you. Thanks for your time. It's been a pleasure having you here.
Thank you. Thank you so much.